like I said, it was a good night of racing, a little bit cold. Like I said, thank all the fans for coming out, and I hope we continue to have some pretty good races here this year. And looking forward to, like I said, the sportsman race tonight. They had quite a few cars. We get the steelhead guys and all this down here. I think we've got a fun place to race.
Well, you know, you know this track just about better than anybody here. I mean, you're a track champion here multiple times. You've raced here, you know, all these years.
Yeah.
How was the track tonight?
It was slick. You know, I mean, it was maneuverable. It wasn't real rough. That sheep's foot spot over there kind of beat us up getting in that corner. But other than that, like I said, for the first race, really, it's good. You know, this thing's been all winter. We've had a lot of rain, a lot of bad weather. So it's pretty good, and hopefully we'll get it better.
Fantastic. Y'all give a big round of applause. Racing out of Mossheim, Tennessee. Third place finisher. Grab the number one. Pick the real hill. Talk to Riley Hickman. Get out of your way here. Riley, congratulations. Second place tonight. And you come from, back right at the end of the top five on the start. And things that happened up front of you, got a second place finish tonight. Congratulations.
Man, we'll take it. You know, we got a brand new piece this week. And I got to thank Ricky Tucker for taking care of us on the race car. And I wasn't really expecting us to get a new race car yet. But it happened, and we'll take it. So, coming here on a new with a new car, and coming out with a second, I can't complain. Congratulations to Chad; he had everybody covered, I believe. I'm not real sure what happened to Chris, but we'll take the attrition part of it and go on.
Yeah, of course, Chris. You know, we had some issues with Chris Madden, Mark Douglas had some problems, had to drop out, put you right up there in the top three, and you hung on to that second position spot. How was the track tonight?
It was good. You know, I think we had actually gotten by Mark and Mac before he had had a problem over there and fell out. But, the track was good. It was slower than I think some of these guys wanted to see. But, you know, it's there wasn't nobody turned over, so that's a good thing.
Who would you like to thank tonight?
I got to thank Hickman Manufacturing, my mom, Angie, and my wife, Angie, and the boys. Vic for giving us a pretty good motor to run. So Hoosier Tire, can't do it without them. So,
all right, congratulations. Y'all give him a big round of applause. Riley Hickman driving the number one. Our race winner out of Sevierville, Tennessee, driving this number 10, Chad Ogle. Y'all give him a big round of applause up there, folks. Congratulations, Chad. I tell you what, now you commanded this thing from the get-go. I mean, from the start, you leaped out to the front. You really didn't have, too many challenges for the lead. You had a couple of the guys that were trying to catch you down low and everything off of 3 and 4. I seen Chris Madden trying to sneak in there a time or two. But you powered off that high line. You seemed to run that high line. You like that high line here at Volunteer Speedway. Who'd you like to thank here tonight, Chad? Sevierville, Tennessee's Chad Ogle. Congratulations, Chad.
The race leader, scoreboard number 14, Robert Bent. Robert Bent, I believe that's how you pronounce that, B-E-A-N-D-T. He's still leading the pack. Now the number 90.
Let's get a word with this very happy gentleman. I keep a spreadsheet on the class computer, and I've had the number 62 on the number of different winners that we've had, and that was since April when Chad became the 62nd different winner, and for the second time at this racetrack, winner number 63 on the history of the series, you finally got your first Carolina Clash victory, and a long time coming.
I'm telling you, it was. You know, this. I can't thank this bunch that I've got, Sean. Hell, I've got so many people to think this thing was a frame, you know, about 14 days ago. And, you know, Sean, Rich busted their butts. Fonsi, I mean, Joey Orr, my wife. I mean, it just took a whole effort to get it done. But, man, these things are good. It's amazing. You come out the first time. We didn't set fast time. We're a little bit late qualifying. But this thing was really good in the race other than the gas flying all over me at the end.
Oh, my goodness. Is that what happened over there?
Yeah, that's why I was like, we got to get started because it was blowing gas out of the fuel line, which is a new car. Things come loose, but that's a bad one to come loose.
Oh, yeah. No kidding. All right. So what do the Southeastern...
I want to get this right here.
Okay. Yeah, this let me get out of the way here.
This is a big part of it's my brother, actually. It's Orthopedic Group. And, you know, without him and John Tweed with Land Air and the other sponsors I've got, you know, I wouldn't have the kind of equipment that I have.
All right, so now, what do the Southeastern late model competitors have to fear now that this one's out of the way, out of the box, big win, there's more wins coming for this one car?
I really think so. Like I said, I got to thank Matthew came over and helped us set this thing up the first time, give us measurements and sizes, and then he said, look, Vic, just do what you do and go take this now. And so we kind of adjusted tonight, wasn't sure we did enough, and this thing's really his steer's really good, and I mean, I can't thank those guys enough. I mean, like I said, I've got a customer of mine that's got one of these now. He's really going to bust my butt to get it done.
And maybe more where that one came from.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
I had a good crowd here tonight. Had a good field of race cars. Thank you for all you do for our series with this racetrack.
Well, you're welcome, and thank you guys for coming. It's always a good group. You know, it's fun to race with good groups of people, and you got a good group, even the racers. And, you know, I talked to the kid beside me on the pole, and he's like, now, don't be jacking around on the starts and some of these people. I said, man, I just race. I said, we'll see how it goes. I said, you're going to beat me on the start, which he did. But anyway, it's fun racing with you guys.
All right, well, thank you, man. And Vic Hill, guys, let's give him one more big round of applause. Woo! Congratulations, buddy.
Race fuels. God, I know I'm forgetting somebody, but Stealth Carburetors, Mom, Dad, Katie, Bingham, Bruce, Tom, Rocky Smith, I mean, everybody, they just keep making it easy on me.
All right, well, you made it look fun for us up there tonight, calling that great action between you and your third-place finisher back here. Good luck to you down the road, buddy. Corey Hedgecock finishing second here tonight. And we'll head over for the final interview here, the top three, this McCarter Lumber Company, McCarter Brothers Racing, car number 51. Pierce McCarter, man, that was some fun stuff to watch in them last 10 laps, you guys dancing around each other. Congratulations on a third-place finish.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah, I had a blast out there. We should have tightened up a little bit more. We didn't quite have the forward traction that Corey had, and I knew he was behind me the whole time. As soon as I seen the 23 get on the board, I knew he'd be there, and we had a great battle going. I'm sure I was holding him up there for a little bit, and I could stay with him getting in and through the center of the corner, but when it came off, I didn't quite have what I needed, but, man, we finished third. I can't complain.
All right, well, appreciate you being here. I'm down Gatlinburg Way. Be careful going home. See you back when we come back in August, I hope. All right, folks, thanks again. All the action, relive it right there on DVD. Speedway Videos, give them a call. Thank you. When we have Carolina Clash, we'll see you in August.
Caution! Caution! We've got one flip-flopped over in turn two. That would be the number four car.
All right, we'll get things started down here with our third-place finisher. Got it right at the end. Jamie Witt driving this number one. Jamie, congratulations.
Well, thank you. Had a hard-fought year down here, and I guess it's the best finish we've got this year, so we'll take it.
Yeah, you had some pretty strong competition up there in front of you. I mean, it looked like that you were going to finish probably in the top five, but then of course, R.J. Mays had a little bit of trouble there with those guys trying to get around him, and he wound up moving back a few places, and that put you right up there in the third place.
Yeah, we always just try to hang in there. You never know what'll happen. And just like thank my sponsors, Iron Horse Race Cars, they build good cars. A little tight tonight, but we learned to get on the bottom and scooted around through there. And B&D Repair and Baldwin Filters, thank you.
All right, congratulations, Jamie Witt. Number two tonight driving this number 88, Vic Chandler. Congratulations, brother.
We don't know. I guess the driver's a little rusty, but he'll get better.
How was the track for you tonight here at Bulls Gap?
It's pretty good there. It's throwing a little dust up down here, made it hard to see it on the lap cars, but it's all right.
It looked like you had a pretty good run up front there with you. I mean, you stayed right up in the top three for the most part, but you get moved up into the number two spot here. RJ, of course, had a little bit of trouble there and had to slow things down a little bit. I noticed he was throwing some sparks there. I think he may have cut a tire, and of course that let you guys move up, but congratulations on a good second place finish.
Okay, we need to finish one anyway.
Who would you like to thank tonight?
Well, my brother and all of them works at TNT Race Cars. They work on this thing. I ain't been got to race it much, but we're going to race a little bit here at the end of the year.
All right, congratulations. Y'all give a big round of applause to number 88, Vic Chandler. This guy right here looked like he had a little bit of a cheering section when he crossed the start-finish line, but congratulations. Tony Horton, big win here at Bulls Gap.
Thank y'all. I'm glad to be here. This place has always been on my bucket list. It's good to get a win here. I got to thank my sponsors, Discount Auto Parts, Bobby's Honda, Presley Farms, Greasy Rock, Clinch River Market, and appreciate everybody coming to watch us.
You had a good, strong car here tonight. I mean, from the get-go, but now you had three or four guys back behind you. Put quite a bit of heat on you on the restarts and stuff. Looked like you did well on the straightaways, but these guys would kind of catch up with you on the turns.
I was being a little conservative. I thought I had a little lead when I got a little bumper. I figured it's time to go.
Well, it's good enough to get the checker tonight. Congratulations. Y'all give me a big round of applause. Tony Horton.
Station. It's a lot of smoke blowing out of that machine down there.
Barrow forward and locks in the number four spot. Now Cook gets up high, gets a little loose, and here comes Dave Smith in the number 10. He's going to move in on the low side as they go into three and four. John Cook riding that high line, and they make contact coming off a four. Contact, and oh, there's a big pile up over in turn in between three and four. Now we've got fire underneath. It looks like the number 16. I believe we got Mike Mays over there in the number 30. And the number 18 of Landon Steele.
S&S Mill Routing Maintenance, number 2M, Shannon Emery. Congratulations, Shannon.
Thank you.
Yeah, had a good race out there. I mean, you had your hands full, but yeah, you always got a good, strong car. You always run up front, and you always run good here at Volunteer Speedway.
Yeah, we've been fighting this new car. We've had a headache out of it for a while. It's giving us a fit. I got to thank Brett Banks for loaning me a spring. Really helped it out a lot. I need to thank Mike Winstead. He's the one that forced a bill on this thing, and we about to get it figured out, I hope.
How was the track here tonight on this Saturday night?
It was slick. It got real dry, and it got real slick. It's a handful.
Hey, you got you a good third-place finish out of it, though. Of course, I mean, you guys are mixing it up front quite a bit.
Yeah, it's a good bunch of people we run with, and I just like to run, have a lot of fun.
Well, you had good fun tonight, finished in third place. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank y'all.
All righty. Shannon Emery in the M2. Auto Shop, Clinch Mountain. Well, you got Discount Auto Parts on here driving this number 56. Tony Horton, congratulations, Tony.
Thank you. Be pretty rough tonight. That's slick, correct.
Yeah, you had a hard fought second place finish here tonight.
That's hard on old man. Man, Kurt's getting old. We're getting too hard or too old for this. It's too slick. I want to say hello to the Presleys up there and thank y'all for coming and watching us tonight.
Who would you like to thank here for helping you out with this car?
Discount Auto Parts, I can't say enough for what these guys do for me. Greasy Rock Auto Shop, Clinch River Market, Gary Seal Coat Company, Bud West Record Service. A lot of good people helps me.
All right, fantastic. Good second place finish on Memorial Day weekend. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right, Tony Horton in the number 56. Longtime racer here at the Speedway, somebody we've seen drive in and out of the victory lane here many, many times. And I'll tell you, this is far cry from that 7-Up Mustang you used to race here.
Yeah, it is. Of course, we used to run these a long time ago, too. But the track was pretty good. The car ran handled super. Missed a little bit there toward the end, but that's okay. I'm just glad to finish.
Now, Kurt, watching you through the first part of the season, I mean, you know, when you guys you were coming in here, it looked like you were kind of still trying to figure the car out, kind of struggling with it early on in the season. But you fought hard, and you run up front here tonight and run a good, strong finish. I mean, you didn't look back when you got out front.
No, we struggled here before. Most of our trouble's been with the car, stuff tiring up and stuff. But hopefully we've got all that straightened out now.
I know you like racing here at the Speedway. How was the track tonight?
Track was good. I liked it, and I like it, I guess.
It got you here with the checkered flag and in victory lane. I guess you do like it tonight, don't you?
Probably most of my wins came when the racetrack was like this here.
All right. Y'all give him a big round of applause. Congratulations, Kurt Owens.
And they are Trey and Tank coming off the turn for position as they're battling for the top four spots. Horton in the lead in the 56. And we've got around over in turn four, brings a caution out on lap number one. Your top cars right now are going to be Horton, Fultz, Hughes, Reese and Owens, and row seven, I believe that is Evans. Oh, power up, over in turn one. We've got four cars sideways. Caution. And since there's four cars, let's just say caution again. So it's caution. Rodney Cowan, we've got a crash on the front straightaway. Caution. Oh, barely missed the number 20. And we got the number 32. Looks like he's lost a little bit of his tire foam down there. Looks like we've got the number 7, Rodney Kiker, down the back straightaway, blowing a lot of smoke as he goes into the turns. I'm going to say it's probably tire smoke. Oh, we've got a caution. We've got one spinning into the wall on front straightaway, the number 27. A hard hit on the inside of the retaining wall. The number 27 of Hughes. Driver's okay. Caution over in 10, number 4 brings up the yellow flag.
Y'all give him a big round of applause driving this 101 to victory lane. Forrest Trent, Forrest, congratulations. I thought you was going to do a flip off the side of that car there for a second.
No, I'm not quite as talented as some of them NASCAR guys.
I'll tell you what a race. I mean, you had Tim Berg and Warren McMahon up in front of you there, two top contenders. and they were tearing up the track. Of course, unfortunately, due to some cautions and everything, those guys had to go to the back. You inherited the lead, and it was nothing but dirt in front.
A lot of things give to me here tonight, and I'm just thankful that we were able to get it done. Made another one of those kind of questionable passes down there, but it worked out for us, so I'm going to keep trying to do it as long as I can get up there.
You had a good, strong car. I mean, even with Tim Bird and McMahon when they were out front, I mean, you were putting some heat on these guys. Who would you like to thank for this car here?
Well, I had a buddy I grew up with riding motorcycles, and he moved to late models just like me, and, man, I've never wanted to win a race so bad for him. Unfortunately, he passed away this week, so this one's for him. I'd like to thank my mom and dad, my girlfriend, Mackenzie, Jeremy. My grandparents are here again. Service 101 Property Management. They take care of all of East Tennessee around through here, so give them a call if you need anything done. Trent Logging, ABG Caulking Waterproofing, Cowtown Farms, RTC, Van Laster Trucking, just everybody that helps us out. I really appreciate it. And we got to go get ready for this super race. I thank you guys. I appreciate it.
All right. Y'all give a big round of applause driving the 101, Forrest Trent. Real quick, we'll talk to the number two finisher tonight driving this number 56, Jody Horton. Congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Hey, how was the track out there tonight?
It's getting slick as the time went on. I was telling him, man, 1, 3, and 4 down there, it was just throw it in there and hope it'd come out. It's getting slick. Really didn't set up for it to turn that slick. This is the only third time I've been here and starting to like it a little bit.
Yeah, not a bad finish for the third time out here, finishing second place. Looked like you had a good, strong car under you. Who'd like to thank for that tonight?
First off, I'd like to thank Discount Auto Parts, RJH Property Solutions, Mikey Knuckles of Warrior Race Cars. He's put me on a shock package this year, man, and I'm telling you, it's turned me around. It really has. Last year, I run Steelheads at Tazewell, and we sold it and got a 604, and we're really enjoying it. It's having fun.
Fantastic. We hope to see you moving up in the lineup there on when we finish here. You know, go from second to first.
Appreciate it.
All right. Congratulations, Jody Horton. All right, our third-place finisher back here driving this number 18. He's no stranger to this track, number 18, Gary Crittenden. Gary, congratulations.
Thank you. It's about time.
About time for a top five anyway. That's a good finish for you tonight.
Yep.
Who would you like to thank?
I'd like to thank my wife, actually. We had a kid there Wednesday, and I talked to her and let me come race.
Ah, congratulations on the new baby then.
Yeah, I'd also like to thank Scotty and Sisway with S&S Millwright, Ben Beto, Tyler Heaton and I, they all helped me out a lot. Couldn't do it.
Fantastic. Good to see you back. We're going to see you back here more through the summer?
Yeah, probably every race, I reckon.
All right, fantastic. Y'all give him a big round of applause. Gary Crittenden into the number 18.
Start, Chris Rickett powers off of turn four, and he's holding on to the lead. Brad Davis right there with him, Tony Horton in third, and another caution with a spin out over in turn four. That's going to be the number 20, bringing out the caution. Trammell threatened the needle as he gets through two of the lappers. And here comes Manley. Caution over in turn two. Third, 32 got caught up.
So who's taking a lesson here tonight over the 2015 season?
It was good. We had to set up a lot of people's marks a little bit. I got a lot of people think Jack McCannon, Mikey Knuckles, Clayton Ramsey. Discount Auto Parts, Harrison, Steve Harrison. I'm leaving out a lot. I got a lot of people to thank. Thank you, fans.
All right, y'all give him a big round of applause. Jordan Horton in the MG. Hard fought battle here for second place. Driving 25-8, Josh Henry. Josh, congratulations.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Had a good finish. I mean, you fought all the way to the end. And, of course, you came up a couple of spots there. Got up in the mix of the top three. Seemed like you tried to dip down on the inside there, but he had the upper hand on the upper part of the track there.
Yeah, the 24, he had a really good car. You know, we started third and fell back to fourth and the race up to second. I thought it was pretty good. If we'd have been a little bit tighter right there, we might have had something for him. But, you know, it's a good race. We didn't tire out too
much. Who'd you like to thank tonight, Josh?
I want to thank my dad. If he wasn't here, I definitely wouldn't be here. I got to thank Driscoll. He does a lot of work for me. If it wasn't for him, we probably wouldn't be here either. Aaron Hayes, Gary Sutton, Brian Hensley, my papa sitting up here. Just anybody, if you've ever touched my car, I appreciate it.
All right, congratulations. Josh Henry, driving the 25. Now we go up there and talk to the man that took the checkered flag, driving this number 24. Tim Byrd, he didn't get the pole, but by golly, he commanded this race from the get-go.
That was a long race. We had about a perfect car, though, the best car I've ever had. So all the hard work over the winter paid off, thank God.
You had a lot of pressure. I mean, you think about the number of restarts we had this race. You had Josh Henry right behind you. You had Jordan Horton right behind you. But for a little bit of time, of course, Warren McMahon was also in there. So you had some pressure on the backside.
Yeah, I know Josh could run me clean, and that's good, though. You know, they were right there. It makes me feel good. But just thank God for a good safe race, and thank TNT and my mother and father and the whole crew, Mark Hamby and my wife, and glad to be back in Victory Lane.
Fantastic. Y'all give a big round of applause. Driving 24, Tim Byrd.
Pushing the car a little bit. We go fast hot rod, so but I got to give a big thanks out to my dad. He's stood behind me, put this thing back together. So I want to thank all these fans. Appreciate it.
You look like you was running real hard. I mean, when you dipped down low and over there in three and four trying to get a move on Tim, and he raced you pretty hard and stayed down low with you and kind of kept you blocked out, but you stayed right in there with him and fought for that lead a couple of times.
Yeah, I had to push the car real hard just to keep up with him there, but Them know where I was trying to get around in there. But like I said, I burnt right front off. Couldn't car start pushing a little bit too much. But we'll see what we can do next week.
All right, congratulations. Third place finisher, Jay Brawls. Number two, finishing in the number two spot, driving this number one machine. Y'all give her up, Mr. Jordan Horton. Jordan, you had a pretty good fight out there on your hands.
Yeah, the car was on. I looked up and I was running third, lap 14. I told myself, just pick them off one at a time. I had a good enough car to win. Mikey helped and Jeremy and all the guys that helped me. I had a good enough car to win. I just laid it a little easy. Should have took advantage a little faster.
You know, Jerry runs pretty strong here. I mean, he's consistent, runs a good race here, and he fought you pretty hard. I mean, keeping held off. I noticed y'all traded a little bit of paint over in two, and he lost quite a bit of real estate on you, and you was able to pull away from him and secure that number two spot.
Yeah, I mean, I always race people like I want to be raced, and I felt like that was good, hard, clean racing. But I got to thank all my sponsors and Jack Buchanan and Warrior Race Cars and all them. We'll be back. We finished third the last time, second this time. We're at her at 24 car.
So it's time for a first place finish next time, right?
Yeah. Thank you, fans, too.
All right. Your second place finisher, Jordan Horton. And your first place finisher, we saw this guy just recently in this same position. Yep. Driving the number 24, Tim Bird. Congratulations again. See you back here in Victory Lane.
Yeah, thank you a lot. It's a great Mother's Day present and great for my whole family and team. I want to thank Unica Force Products, RDM Trucking, and my daughter, Brittany Bird, and the first time she's been in Victory Lane with me. And I know Jerry was hot on my heels there, and we just kept digging and had a good car.
He did. I was talking to him. I noticed, you know, you guys kind of stayed up in the middle groove over in one and two, and then when you get over here in three and four, he'd always dip down, look on that inside. You stayed right down there with him.
Yeah, there was a few bad ripples in high in three and four, and it's hard to run up there, but we had a great car and just had to stay on top of it.
All right, we'd like to see you back here in Victory Lane again sometime this season.
We'll try our best.
All right. Congratulations, driver number 24, Tim Bird.
Jason Trammell rolling out way ahead of Estes in the 31. And the number 21 gets up high and goes into Dale Ball and gets himself crossed up and takes more contact. Now sits idle on the back straightaway. The number 21.
That one car has come to life. Up behind the six. Oh, trouble on the front straightaway. Joey Coulter right in front of the field. And Wilson had nowhere to go. I mean, there was nowhere to go. They could not get slowed down fast enough. Vic Hill got tagged. It was minimal, just a little bit of contact. But, you know, these things are so engineered to the nearest degree. I mean, you can't do anything. You can't really touch these things in any fashion. So any kind of contact like that can move a bar. It could move a link, or anything could happen. So let's see if that has affected.
All right, we'll start this interview off. Their third place finisher driving this double zero. Pretty well-known driver here at Volunteer Speedway. Remember when you used to tear up these high banks in that open wheel? Stanley Donahue, back here. Congratulations.
Thank you. Had a good run. Couldn't do it without my family that helps me. My dad, my father-in-law, Perry Coleman, my wife, and the crew that comes and help me, Jacob, Tony. Without their help, I couldn't be doing this late model racing. And I'd like to wish everybody, all the mothers out there, happy Mother's Day tomorrow. And my wife, a happy 18th anniversary tomorrow. So,
congratulations. Yeah, you had a good, strong car tonight. He's hanging in there at second place pretty well. I thought maybe you might jump in there to the lead a time or two.
It was decent. Right rear tire gave out. I see where it's chunked up pretty good, so we might have been picking on the right rear a little too hard. We're getting there. I think we're getting out horsepower pretty good. I wish they kept the rules on a flat top piston. Now these guys are a step ahead of us on motor, so it shows up when we're going down the straightaway. Anyway, we're getting there. We're close, so maybe we can get some wins soon.
All right, well, good finish. Third place tonight. Y'all give him a round of applause. Driving a double zero, Stanley Donahue. Interview with our number two finisher. Driving is number 72, Barrett Lowe. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Who would you like to thank tonight?
I got to thank my dad, my grandpa, and Vic Hill for the engine, and Dalton 66, Ultra Shield, West Haven. That's about it.
You had a good race tonight. I mean, you started out a little bit more back in the field, but you came up pretty quick, and you put a good, strong fight up there for that lead.
Yeah, we had a good piece. It just ran out of time.
You know, Trevor was running away from just about everybody early on in this race, but you come on pretty hard there towards the end. And, I mean, you finished just within a couple of car lengths. I mean, if you had about four or five more laps, I think you might have been able to creep up or maybe make a pass on it.
Yeah, maybe we'll be in the right position next time.
Congratulations on a good second place finish, Barrett Lowe. And a good finish for this young man driving this number 73, Trevor Seiss. Congratulations.
Thank you.
As a good finish, I mean, you commanded this thing from the get-go. And at one point, I mean, you jumped way out to a good lead over these guys. You looked like you were pretty comfortable out there. And then you had a couple of these guys close in on you pretty hard towards the end. It's a pretty good hard-fought finish.
Yeah, the car was really good. Then we had that really long caution, and the rear tires just sealed up, and it lost forward traction.
Who would you like to thank tonight on this win?
I'd like to thank Kistner Knives, McLean Speed Shop, Warrior Race Cars, The Bed Store, Jones Pest Control, Harrison Construction, Vic Hill Racing Engines, Diamond Shine Pressure Washing, and B&M Concrete.
Of course, you got $2,000 extra dollars going in your pocket tonight, too.
Yeah, I sure do. But I would like to thank my mom and dad and everyone that comes with me standing out here. They help me get here every single week.
All right, fantastic. Good finish for this young man driving to number 73.
Looks like we've got one stopped on the back straightaway.
And Greg Estes on the pole. Here's Vic Chandler driving the number 88. Just about guarantee this guy's going to be in the running for one of the top spots. See what Vic does here. Oh, gets squirrely off. Oh, spins it around on the front straightaway. Keeps it out of the wall. What a way to handle that machine and keep it from getting damaged. Sets the pace as they come off of turn four around the corner. Three wide race in action off of turn two as they battle for position. Now they're three and four wide. Oh, and we've got a mess up over in turn four. Several cars involved as we had a couple go around and then it collected several others. I see several.
We'll start back here with our third-place finisher as he climbs out of the cockpit with a little sigh of relief. That was a hard-fought battle. John Twee, the number five. You got a good third-place finish tonight.
Yeah, we're happy with that. I don't think I've been in a car in about 3.5 months, so I got to thank Sanchez and Eric and all the guys, Vic, of course, for fixing me up a fast race car. And I appreciate all the people out there racing with it, Phyllis and Joe, and just thank everybody. We had a good time tonight, and this is what racing's all about.
How was the track for you tonight? I mean, you had some good heat on you. These guys up front, they were racing hard, but, you got a good third-place finish, but it was a hard-fought third place.
You know, I'd like to race on it first tonight. It was really good hot lapping. It got a little slick on us, but, that's what it's all about. We had a good time. Thank you very much.
All right, third-place finisher, John Tweed. All right, second place finisher driving at number 31. Another good hard fought finish. Greg Estes, boy, you had a tough battle here tonight.
Yeah, I had nothing for Jason. He was just he was a rocket. He was hooked up.
You had some good competition on you there from the backside. I mean, the whole race long. You know, we had a good mix of these guys just changing some spots, you know, sliding around up in some of the turns and stuff. But you got up here and held on to this second place spot.
Yeah, on that initial start, I don't know if I guess my right front was cold or I had a little mud on it or something, but it took me about a lap to get the push out of it, and then I was, you know, able to settle down. By then, Jason got around me, and I was just content to follow them around. And I thought the track would slick off, and the cushion wouldn't develop on both ends like it has. And you know, when that cushion stayed there, and the traction stayed there, and Jason was on that cushion, and every time he'd miss the cushion and have to get out, I'd miss the cushion and have to get out. So I couldn't win for losing.
Just couldn't seem to time it right tonight. Who would you like to thank?
I got to thank Vic Hill, of course, for you know, he takes care of this Longhorn, and he's got his engine in it. And Powell Valley Bank, Estes Brothers Construction, my dad, Robert. My daughter, Parker, came in eighth while I go in that pretty Camaro of hers, and she'll be in this thing one of these days. Everybody back in Lee County.
All right. Y'all give a big round of applause. Good second place finish. Congratulations, Greg Estes. I just got word here. Jason, they said that this car was 14 years old and that this was the 75th win in this car, the number 90. 75 wins on this car. Yep. So congratulations. Good run tonight.
Thank you. I'd like to thank God. That is my 75th win on this one car, my 90th win total. So big 9-0 for the 90.
Wow.
But I'd like to three fast lane cars in the top three, three Vic Hill race engines. I'd like to thank my dad and all my crew. One of my tire guy today is his birthday, so we get to celebrate his birthday in Victory Lane.
Yeah, you had a little bit of a jump there on the first start. Of course, they called you back around for another even start. Greg said he thinks he might have got just a little caught up there on that restart because he didn't get right up with you on that cone. But you had a good start, got around him, and you held this thing from the get-go. How was the track?
The track was good. You had to be really careful getting into one and two. There was a couple times I jumped the cushion up there, and I was like, oh, goodness, if Greg's right here, he's done past me. But luckily, he wasn't there, and I held it off, and I just made sure in one and two that I didn't charge it too hard and jump it, because if I jumped it, it would just pretty much stop your car. But the car was good all night, and I like I say, my crew's awesome. I thank God again for a good night, and we've had a really up-and-down year with stuff breaking, leading, and tonight, it sure will help that.
All right. Good. Congratulations on a 90th win in the 9-0. Y'all give him a big round of applause. Jason Trammell.
All right, so here we go with the restart. Greg Estes still with the lead. Gary Blank in the number 5 car now riding in the second place and trying to hold off that number 4. Actually, trying to hold off that 88 of Brad Davis. Caution, all in turn 2. Two cars involved. Looks like off the turn. Three and four wide off the turn four. We've got one lap in. Tim Bird leads the pack around. It's Tim Bird with the lead. Forrest Tritt rides in second. Caution, caution. Over in two. Two cars involved. Brings out the caution. We just got one lap in, and we're already on caution. I think number 3 is Trent now with the lead. He takes Tim Bird over into 3 and 4. Back behind him, David Smith in the number 11 car. Caution on the track. Down on the front straightaway. So the 25 gets down in the dirt, so the 44. Spot. 32 and the 23 battling it out door to door as they go into 3. Oh, and we've got a spin out over in 3 and 4, and it's going to collect another. No, it looks like they're going to miss. Stays down low, stays out of the wreck, but we've got a caution on lap number 27.
This has got to be like a win for you for what that car looked like in qualifying, and then work yourself from 12th place all the way to 3rd. What a run for Ben Watkins.
Oh, man, it was that was a fight right there. You know, we kind of got behind there at the beginning of the night. But, man, I got to give it to my crew guys. Didn't give up, you know, just worked on it. You know, and we just put it together. I got to give all the glory to God. Thank him. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here. But, man, my hat's off to these guys as well.
All right, the car looked like it got better as the race went on.
Yeah, it did. We kind of gambled on the right rear tire, and it paid off at the beginning and kind of went there later, and just luckily we were to manage, you know, the third place, and we'll take it.
There you go. Good run. Good finish. Best finish here at the gap for Ben Watkins, coming from 12th to finish 3rd. Lap on lap number 22. That was a fast lap around. You put around this racetrack a 12.198. Vic Hill had a 103 right behind you. It seemed like when you would get a fast lap, he would have the fast lap. Then you'd get the fast lap, and then he'd get the fast lap. Good race car early, kind of settled in for 2nd overall.
We had a good car. I think our tire choice was a little too hard on the right rear, but my guys make so many good calls, I can't be hard on them. So awesome race car night. I can't thank Larry Garner and Blunt Motorsports, all our sponsors, Stowers Cat, Tennessee RV. Everybody that makes this racing possible, I'm so blessed to be able to drive this thing. Man, what a fast racetrack tonight.
It did, and it very much got faster as the race went on. It appeared from a 381 in qualifying to a 198 in the race.
Yeah, no doubt. It was definitely a hammer down, hold on as fast as you could go, but awesome night. Congratulations to Mark Douglas. He drove a great race.
All right, well, we're going to head over to talk to him now. Donald McIntosh coming home 2nd in that 7 car. All right, he's getting ready to get the big check. He's got the belt already in hand. We have crowned a bunch of new winners on our series, and you are going to be the newest new winner of Carolina Clash Racing here at Volunteer. Congratulations to car number 52, Mark Douglas, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks, everybody, for coming out. I'd like to thank all my sponsors, Sea Laney & Sons Construction, McLean Speed Shop, Rocket Race Cars, David Bryant for helping me a lot through the whenever I got started and all that stuff. I really appreciate a lot for him. And Dad and everybody that helps me, and brother, and everybody's got a part of it. Just hard, so hard to race anymore. It's just everything costs so much, and we're just out here digging, trying to race to put on a show for the fans.
Where does this one rank? And you've won races before. This one's got to be pretty special for you.
Yeah, it's a long time coming. We've been in a drought for, I don't know, probably 2 years, I guess, or maybe a little longer. We won a lot of races up here, and it just brings back memories. I'm just finally glad to put one in Victory Circle for a change, not have bad luck.
All right, well, definitely that last caution was probably in your mind going, what, why now?
Yeah, I just like, man, not 4 to go. It's pretty much a bottom middle groove. It's just going to be hard for, I think McIntosh might have been 2nd, I'm not for sure, or Vic, one of the two. But, I just said, well, if I just hit my marks, don't let it push, or I should be okay. So it all worked out, and like I said, I appreciate all the fans coming out and supporting Volunteer Speedway and supporting us in the racing.
All right, congratulations, Volunteer. Let's hear it for your winner tonight. Let's hear it for him. Mark Douglas is your winner, and thank you, Speedway Videos. Get it online. Go to talk to them at Speedway Videos. They will have the replay. And watch this car come to Victory Lane for the Clash at the Gap. $4,000 for Mark Douglas. Congratulations. Race fans, give him one more hand of applause.
Caution, over in the middle.
several cars involved in a pile up over in one and two. Charlie Bates, I see in that miss. On the track now as he comes down the back straightaway, right in the middle groove in three and four. Slides into four, good line as he comes onto the front straightaway, and he's going to turn a 13.644, Johnny Ridings.
All right, we got to say congratulations to the driver. This is number 43. What a fantastic finish. Marley Grant, you come all the way down here from Kentucky to race here tonight. What do you think?
Oh, I love this place, man. You can race all over it.
You raced all over it tonight. I tell you what, I mean, you kind of started that back there, you know, a little bit towards the middle part of the front part of the pack, but you worked your way up. And, man, what a finish. What a finish to come up in the third.
Oh, I love it, man. You come to Tennessee to race these modified street guys, you better pack your lunch. They're tough.
What'd you think of the track here tonight?
Awesome race service, awesome prep, and it's crazy fast for its size.
Who would you like to thank here tonight, Barley?
I'd like to thank my mother. The reason this car is a Petty car, she's a big Petty fan. She's got COPD, don't get to come to the races anymore. So we've done a car kind of to make her happy. American Racer South, AR Bodies, Rainmaker Race Cars, and Adam Chassis.
Fantastic. Well, I'll tell you what, come back here again, race with us again here at Volunteer Speedway. We want to see you back here again.
Be back about 2 weeks.
Fantastic. Barley Grant finishing third, and this is number 43. Y'all give him a round of applause, folks. We got to say congratulations, of course, to Wesley Lester. I mean, what a strong finish he had to come up with that second-place finish. Don't know where he wound up at, but we was looking for him out here on the front straightaway to congratulate him, but what a good race he ran here tonight. But I tell you what, spotlight's on this guy right here, $1,000 richer, number 31, Greg Estes. Congratulations.
I appreciate it. I got to thank Richard Cox. He took the car over this year, and this thing is just immaculate. I mean, it's so well-maintained. You know, you could drive it with one hand if you wanted to. It's just a Sunday drive. But it's really tough to lead every lap because, and I saw a couple of noses. I know Kurt was under me. I'm not sure who else got under me, maybe Gary. And that got me thinking I need to move a little bit. So then I started arcing off down in turn three and dropping off the bottom. And all my people were saying, yeah, you're doing okay. You got to lead. So that was tough.
You had quite a bit of heat on you a couple of different times, you know. We really didn't have a lead change, but second, third place back behind you, there was a lot of shifting back there. Of course, you had Kurt Owens going in. Gary Blanken was hot on you there for a little while, and then he had to go in, had some issues. Shannon Emery was running up there for a little bit. So, you know, you held your own pretty good with some pretty tough competition.
Yeah, this is like a fall brawl field. I mean, this is the best of the best in street cars. I looked up there and I saw the scoreboard every caution, and it was changing around, second, third, fourth, and I wasn't sure who I was racing. You know, I've raced with Gary a long time, and I've raced with a lot of those guys, you know, Shannon and them several times, but some of those guys I didn't know what to expect.
Who would you like to thank tonight to help you work on this car?
Well, I want to thank Vic for putting an awesome Vic Hill engine in this thing, and Richard Cox, you know, he takes care of it during the week and brings it to the track and just babies it. I want to thank my dad. He comes to all the races. I want to thank my wife and my mom, and happy Mother's Day. It's probably Mother's Day by now. And all the moms out there.
All right, well, congratulations. Hopefully we'll see you back here in a couple of weeks.
Absolutely.
All right, y'all give a round of applause. Driving number 31, Greg Estes.
Our speed's currently getting up around 86, 87 miles an hour is where they're topping out. Gary Blanken is in second place. Looks like we have car's gotten clipped, left and rear goes to spin.
14.692 for Williams on his first go-round. Oh, and he spins around over in turn two. So Jerry Williams gets side. Bobby Mays gets spun out over in turn four, tries to keep his wheels rolling, nothing doing, going to bring out the caution, and that's going to put Mays to the back of the pack. The number 25, tough break. Bobby Mays was
third place finisher tonight, driving the number two, Tim Maupin. Congratulations, Tim. Good finish. Sound like you got a cheering section down here.
Yeah, it's pretty good. I had a good run going there before the last caution. I thought I was going to go somewhere, but that's the way it goes. It didn't fire off as good on the last as I thought it was going to. But I'm glad to be up here. Had to rebuild it before the last race, so I hope it stays together and keep getting faster.
You had a pretty hard-fought battle just holding on and getting up to third place. I mean, between Marty Callaway being in the mix before he had to drop out, you had Gary Crittenden coming up there. Of course, you're battling, trying to gain ground on Tim Bird here, the number 24. I mean, you had some pretty solid competition up front tonight.
Yeah, it was one lane up here, so I kind of, the 79, I kind of owe him an apology. I used him up a little bit, but I did all I could do to hold it off of him. But that's racing. I couldn't hold it down. But, yeah, it was a good race. Everybody done good.
Who would you like to thank tonight, Tim?
Everybody that's helped get it going. Dale, he helps me a lot, teaches me a lot. Alan, it's a... hard to do.
Well, you got a good third place finish out of it. Congratulations on a good finish tonight here at Volunteer Speedway.
Thank you.
Tim Maupin, y'all give him a round of applause. Good hard fought second place finish for the number 24, Tim Bird, if I can get my microphone working here. Congratulations, Tim.
You sound like me. I'm about half sick and can't talk, whatever there.
I think it's my microphone is sick tonight. It's the microphone, not me.
Yeah, we had a good run. I didn't have nothing for Jerry there, though. had a missing problem in my car, but altogether, it's a good night.
Now, if you could have had that missing problem fixed, you think you could have given Jerry a little bit more?
I don't think so. You get out in front in these races, you know, it's pretty hard to pass somebody, you know, clean stuff. But
yeah, it's a pretty good heat on you coming up from behind you, too.
Yeah, I know this back there. You got to keep it rolling.
Who would you like to thank tonight, Tim?
I'd like to thank RDM Trucking, Unica Force Products, and Mark Hammy there, and my family, and most of all, good man above.
All right, congratulations. Big round of applause, Tim Bird. Right here, checkered flag winner, Jerry Brawls. Jerry, congratulations.
Well, thank you. We've had a pretty bad season this year. We ain't got to run a lot. We finished fifth down there a couple weeks ago, but other than that, we really ain't put a solid finish together tonight. We've been really working hard on this thing. I mean, we spent 2 days on the front geometry on the last 2 days, and it's really paid off.
You know, you got a pretty good fan base here at Volunteer Speedway, and you like racing here, don't you?
Oh, yeah, this home track right here, these fans right here, seeing these kids step through here, that's what makes it all worthwhile. If I had the trophy here, I'd give it to one of them, but they're up top. I'm sorry.
Who would you like to thank tonight, Jerry?
Oh, I got to thank God for one. That's it, my daddy. He lives and breathes this racing. If it wasn't for him, I would not be still doing this. I got to thank my wife and my two boys. They put up with a lot with two cars and everything, but after tonight, they'll be a whole lot happier.
All right, well, congratulations on a good checkered flag finish tonight. Y'all give a big round of applause, Jerry Brawls.
And that'll take us to a yellow flag.
I guess it's been 20 years since I started here, and I've never finished in the top five, so this is a great night. I'll always remember this one.
It sounds like you got a few fans up in the crowd. Who would you like to thank tonight?
Yeah, well, I'd like to thank my dad, who's come with me all 20 years, and my mom sitting up in the stands. She's come to my first one, and she's there tonight. So there's the two big ones, and thanks to everybody else for coming out tonight, supporting the Volunteer Speedway.
All right, fantastic. Y'all give him a big round of applause again. Richard Atkins driving this number 73. Hurst, Taryn, good run tonight.
Oh, thanks, man. A little nervous. I've never talked in front of this many people before.
Well, sounds like you got a contingency of fans up in the stands, plus down here in the infield are rooting for you.
Oh, yeah, they're great. I'd like to thank Jeff Hurst, my uncle, Tony Wheeler, my uncle, Miranda, my girlfriend, my mom, my sister, my whole family, Ricky Moore, Moore's Auto Sales, Dairy Dream, Hooker Trucking, Gwen's, Lawnscape, TNT Race Cars, they build great stuff there. Most of all, I'd like to thank the Lord. You know, if it wasn't for him, man, none of us would be here right now. And I thank him for allowing us to know the great sport of dirt track racing.
Fantastic. I tell you what, you started out good. You know, you had the lead in this thing there for a little bit. But, you know, you held on strong for a good second place finish against the guy up there that took the checkered flag. How was the track tonight?
Oh, the track's in a lot. I mean, it's getting a lot better than it's been before. I like it. I forgot to thank S&S Millwright. But yeah, car started pushing a little bit, but I mean, we're young, the whole team. I mean, we're green, but we'll get there one day.
All right, fantastic. One more time, give a round of applause. Taryn Hurst. I'm going to be talking to the man that took the checkered flag. Once again, this race tonight brought to you by Moore's Auto Sales and Tire Center out of Mossheim, and of course, Tolliver Heating and Air. Driving this number 25, our winner tonight of our B main feature. This is Eric Weber. Eric, congratulations. Good win.
Appreciate it. Yeah, it's first year in this car, so first win I've actually had. So I'm pretty happy, even though it's a B main. So if we can do it in the feature, it'd be nice.
Yeah, even if it's a B main, see that checkered flag? It's a good sight, ain't it, out that front windshield?
Yeah, sure is, yep.
Who would you like to thank tonight in the way of sponsors?
I got to thank Phillips Excavating. I got to thank Apaches over here. He works his butt off on this car. Precision Collision, Tennessee Fence, Rex Effects, Custom Graphics.
How was the track here tonight against these guys?
Track's good. It's good and tacky. It'll be all right.
Be all right. You going to be back and try to get that checkered flag again?
I hope.
All right, fantastic. One more time, number 25, Eric Weber, your winner of the B-Main feature tonight, brought to you by Moore's Auto Sales and Tire Center, and, of course, Tolliver Heating and Air.
Ricky Moore and Jensen Ford. Well, they were even by the cone, and then as soon as they got by the cone, the inside line took off like a rocket. So they're calling it a good start. Jensen Ford, oh, and we've got a pile up almost. Can they save it? No! We've got twisted metal all over turn four. Tim Bird goes to the infield with damage to the number 24. We've got three cars sitting idle. It looks like we've got one rolling. Warren McMahon rolling down towards the lower line there. The number 33 looks like Dale Ball. And the number 2 might have gotten some damage as he rolls to the lower portion of the front stretch.
Y'all give him a big round of applause as he climbs out of the cockpit. Vic Chandler in the number 88.
Congratulations, Chris. That's a good strong second place finish. You had some tough competition out there tonight.
Yeah, everybody's pretty fast. We were trying a new setup tonight on the car, and we missed it just a little bit. We were a little too tight to run with Jensen, but we were all pretty good.
Who would you like to thank tonight for on this good, strong finish you had here?
Well, first off, I want to thank my family, my brother Vic and Brian, he's my crew chief, and my brother Vincent. They all help us all week at the shop. And I want to thank Tony and Teresa and Jensen. They're actually my employers. I work at TNT Race Cars. So I want to thank them.
All right, fantastic. Good, strong finish. Big round of applause. Driving number 88, Chris Chandler. And, of course, driving from up around to Johnson City, Jonesboro, Limestone area, driving this number 83. I see the Punisher logo on the top of this car, Jensen. Good finish tonight.
Thank you. Yeah, we had a problem with our steelhead motor there a couple weeks ago, the last time we was down here, and messed a piston up, and we thought we was going to pull a crate motor we had sitting out in the garage. It's been sitting there over a year, and we run a couple times at Whiffle, and you know, we've been trying to do that steelhead deal, and we started doing that, and I realized I was behind on my setup stuff, and I went to work. It took me a long time to get where I needed to be, and we've been having motor trouble this year, and I know the car is good, and, you know.
It didn't look like you had any motor issues tonight, brother.
It's struggling. Like I say, it needs fresh, and it's got probably 30 races on it.
Well, if it was struggling tonight, I'd hate to see what you're looking like when it's running like a sewing machine, you know.
Car was really good tonight. I mean, I went to work on my car, man, and I got it where it needs to be. When I get that steelhead motor back in, steelhead boy's gonna be in trouble too. So
you jumped out to a lead and basically never looked back, even on the restarts that we had. I mean, you jumped out to a quick lead on these guys and held it from the get-go.
Yeah, like I say, man, this car's so good. I've been working on it for a long time. It's took me a long time to get it back to where I really needed. I went for years thinking I was all right, and you know, when you go and do the same thing over and over, you just got to have something different. And, you know, we went to work, and we got something real good right now.
Well, you're all right tonight. Who would you like to thank for this win?
Charlie Bird, Tim Bird, for letting me run this car. This car I built there a couple years ago, and we finally got it going here pretty good. RDM Trucking, Unica Forest Products, Charles Bird Logging, AFCO Racing Products, just everybody that helps us out. Mark helps us out every week, you know, getting these cars ready. If it wasn't for everybody, you know, we'd have a hard time doing this.
Fantastic. Y'all give him a big round of applause once again, driving this number 83, Jensen Ford.